looking at this guy called Average Joe CT, he does some back therapy videos and stuff. I was in his live stream asking him questions the other night. He said, it sounds like you're two for us every day. I said, yeah. He said, yeah, you're kind of the opposite of what basketball that most people have. I was like, yeah, maybe so. Because I got that real lower back, and I'm very flexible. I can actually, like, stand straight up and put my arm on. So, like, he says, I need that extra stretch in the low versus the 70% up here. Kind of take a lot for me to do any kind of back exercises, you know. I'm not a freaking go-to person or anything like that. Never have stuff like that. Continue doing what we're doing and not fall into traps. And you know, Sean, I still don't do very well financially with this thing. So it works out. There's always a little money in it, you know, before just gotta invest a little bit here and there. Whatever plan I had, it made sense on paper when I looked at it, but honestly, you know, there's no bank seeing the lines or let somebody borrow money to open a hair salon or a restaurant or a bar, you know. It's just not that easy, you know.
It's like you gotta have a 5-year plan, how you
doing? Yeah. I wanted to go to the bank for the show, it's just so average that we don't. Save some money over a few years. It's a long way. Let's not save some money. Pulled it all out. It was like two big rolls, $100 bills. I'm like, guys, this is what we're going to do right here. And I did everything. Equipment, buying the products, preparing for the plants. Paid it back pretty quick. They got a salon back there where they sell products cheap.
That ain't normal. I mean, like Mother's
Day. I don't know that I'd recommend ever getting your hair done there.
I don't get my hair done there.
Hire a hairstylist that don't know what they're doing so they can sit there and sell free products.
I just like their cheap prices for the hair products.
Yeah. Yeah, they ain't no different than other stuff. Plus, it's money, some products. don't use water, we don't use something, we don't use something, we don't get it. Little carry, little round, a pocket stock, or whatever, it's like.
Do they have a spread today?
Yeah, you can probably tell about a 3 year shelf life anyway. So, I'd say 2 years, something in the last 5 years, you know, but it's just a little bit.
My cage, my zircon, I've had that stuff like 4 years. Cause it don't take a lot.
As long as it doesn't get hot, it'll be fine, you know. But that, particularly with Joico, if it gets hot, it'll separate.
But I mean, it's in my house, so it don't get hot.
Yeah.
But it's almost gone, now I gotta catch it on sale somewhere. That stuff's pricey. $25, mine's $30. It's $25, I bought it when you were at 13th Street, so. Well, for $35, it lasts that long, it's really not a bad price. And you think, if I buy Pantene for $6 a bottle, you know.
And have to buy
it every 6 months.
Yeah.
Well, probably 4 months. But like my Biolage, I get the, that size, and it lasts me a good year. So I catch it on sale, I can get both bottles for $30. So same price if I was keep mine in Walmart.
And obviously, Novak's got a great serving rhythm, and great serving and first shot pattern. So Stan's got to reinvest real quickly now and try to disrupt that.
I don't think I'm in the world.
Tim, right with your hair. Look at her eyes, man. Look at those sunglasses on, man.
I like when you get like that. I woke up this morning, I was like, what the fuck am I doing?
One time I had to play matching tennis with my glasses on because my contacts were ripped. And I don't know what happened. The angle of the sun hit the lenses and it would bounce up. And after the match, I had 2 scars on my forehead, like 3 or 3
Oh my God!
Burned Dickens out of me. Holy crap, I went into the clubhouse and I felt my forehead burning. And I thought I was just overheated or whatever, but I went in the back and looked in the mirror. It was like the perfect picture of my lens of my glasses, you know.
Oh,
and I said, that is crazy looking. And then I realized how bad that my forehead was just burning, you know. It blistered up, so. Yeah, I remember I had that match and I was getting ready to go that morning. I put my contact in and banged it and ripped, and it was the last one I had. So I had one contact. And when I asked for something like this,
yeah.
I got to break out my glasses, which every time I fall forward, they fall off my face. So I had to put some rubber bands behind my ears to hold them on.
Oh my God.
And like, they were just glued to my face during the match. And it was like in August, it was 100 degrees on the court. And the sun was beating down, and the reflection just reflected down and up through my lens like a magnifying glass. It burned me bad.
Mm-hmm.
too. Is that true? Mm-hmm.
And you'll have a second break chance. Tremendous court coverage by Stan.
Happy to get in and get you all in today. Just have to think about putting it off too far.
Yeah. You got more today?
I'm only going to book one or two things a day. And I need to really kind of be doing it. Wait, fix this person. Just in case they do pop by the police or the state board. You know, it might be that they told the police to just go around and check some lines, and you know, you never know. I don't want to hassle them. I don't want to take the paper down today, so I don't want to be harassed for like at least 10 days for the public. Because everybody is going to be looking for her at this week. Mm-hmm. Everybody. And I'm just taking my appointments on this. So. Mm-hmm. I guess. If you got, you know, your next appointment, it's supposed to be way out in the car.
Yeah, I called and made an appointment for my boss. And she said, okay, well, when he gets here, he needs to let me know he's here. He needs to wear a mask, wait in the car, and I'll call him when I'm ready. Mm.
We've been doing that for beauty supply last. See, they got a beauty supply house. He comes out and wearing a respirator and the main sweater. Oh, shit. He's like, she kind of
damn.
Sickness.
The one behind Walmart?
You know him?
No, when Bonnie comes in the town.
Oh, yeah. They got new owners. It used to be the Munns, you know. But,
well, I didn't think you were going over to Shanique was by Taco Bell.
Justin?
You know that one right there? She's all weeds? Yeah.
Is that where you get our hair supplies?
What's that?
Do you get our hair supplies from the Taco Bell one?
Oh, that I've been back there. Man, that place is a freak house. Oh my God. My mom and Paul were first went over there. I was like, you did not. You didn't go back there, Mama. She said, yeah, she told me it was real hair.
Oh my God.
Or a hybrid of fake and real. I said, a hybrid? I'm not going to be able to blow dry that. Oh, that was another thing I saw in the paper. We're not supposed to use our blow dryers.
What?
Yeah, man, we can't blow dry hair, man.
Why?
Because it makes things circulate, they said.
Oh my God.
Yeah, crazy, man. That
don't even make sense.
Why would you even go even just to get it styled if you can't get it blow dried?
Well, my feelings is, you know, if you're worried about the blow dryers blowing that shit around, then we shouldn't be there in the first place.
Exactly.
You know, like, that's crazy, man.
You need to stop.
Obviously not paying any attention to anything. And I was like, my place is clean, you know? I was cleaning it, like, before all this even got right to us, man.
Is he supposed to come on at 2:30 today?
I'm there. I
don't know.
They got Mark
Barnes
in it.
They got Bill Clinton and Monica's night. Oh God.
Hell yeah, man. Oh my God. Oh my God.